This is an SEC, Securities and Exchange Commission officer, now being presented as a witness under Article 2. What is the relevance of this witness to Article 2?
I'll just give the floor to Congressman Ray O'Malley, who will conduct the direct examination. Congressman O'Malley, Mr. President.
Yes, but the chair would like to know the relevance of the SEC in this proceeding. Will counsel please explain?
Thank you, Mr. Senate President, Your Honors. Let me just explain, Your Honor, that the relevance of presenting this SEC official is to amplify on points pertaining to the Basa Gidote Enterprise Inc., which appeared in the SAL ends, or Statement of Assets, Liabilities, and Net Worth, which was hesitantly presented by the Clerk of Court of the Supreme Court. And in this particular SAL ends, particularly Exhibit C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, and L, which were also adopted as common exhibits by the defense, the name of Basa Gidote Enterprise Inc., where it showed that there was a cash advance of $11 million was reflected in the liabilities column of the SAL ends, Your Honor.
Cash advance of the corporation to whom?
Allegedly to Renato Corona, the respondent in this case.
How would the SEC know about the details of a cash advance by corporation to someone?
Yes, Your Honor.
Their duty is only to record the records of a corporation.
Yes, Your Honor. That's why in this particular instance, the prosecution will prove that as of 2003, calendar and fiscal year 2003, this Basa Gidote Enterprises Inc., Your Honors, had been revoked, and therefore its corporate existence.
Revoked,
yes, Your Honor. The license, corporate franchise.
The license has been revoked.
Yes, Your Honor.
Revoked.
Yes, Your Honor.
To operate as a corporation, but it was not dissolved as an artificial person. Was it dissolved as an artificial person by the revocation?
As a juridical person, Your Honor.
That's right. Was it revoked?
Yes, Your Honor.
As a juridical person, I doubt it.
Yes, Your Honor.
The only one that can dissolve it are the stockholders.
No, Your Honor. What happened here was for failure to comply with the reportorial requirements as required under the Corporation Code, and this happened from 1990 to date, Your Honor.
This is a legal question, whether the order of the SEC to prevent the corporation to transact any business because of certain non-fulfillment of regulation would mean a disillusion of a corporation, although this is a legal question. Let's hear the witness. Okay, you proceed.
Yes, Your Honor. Thank you, Your Honor.
It's up to the defense counsel to protect the interest of his client.
If Your Honor, please, may I be allowed to say a couple of points?
Please, go ahead.
If the witness on the stand, Your Honor, will be testifying on legal matters, I do not think that could be the subject of his testimony, because as a witness, what can be covered by the testimony of a witness are only factual matters, never legal matters, Your Honor.
Precisely,
because that should be addressed. I'm sorry, Your Honor.
Precisely that the chair asked whether he was, what is his relevance. And now it turns out that he's going to discuss a theory that has not been established by, I don't know of any jurisprudence that can be cited about this, but I would like to give them all the opportunities to prove their case, and let us hear the testimony.
We'll just make up. May I be allowed?
Yes, Honor? Please.
We will just make up record, Your Honor, our objection to this kind of testimony, Your Honor, because if it deals with legal matters, then the witness will be entirely incompetent, irrelevant.
Yeah, yeah. You can register your objection.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Yeah, proceed.
We did.
Mr. President.
The majority floor leader.
Mr. President, before the clerk of court swears in the witness, the clerk of court, also of the impeachment court, would like to inform the body that they have served the subpoena to the senior vice president of Mega World 9 a.m. this morning. Received 9 a.m. this morning, but was asked to appear at 2 o'clock this afternoon, today, not tomorrow. At 2 o'clock in the afternoon, at the 31st day of January, for the record.
Was there any return showing that he received the service?
Yes, at 9 a.m. This morning, Mr. President.
Well, we will cite him for contempt.
May we know if he is around, Your Honor?
We will cite him for contempt for not complying with the order of this court.
Mr. President, we've been informed that he's here just now.
He's here.
Yes. Would you be informed?
Then put him in the witness stand first.
He just arrived now. Ngayon lang ba doon lang?
We were informed, Mr. President, that he just arrived now, so he's here.
So what is the pleasure of the prosecution now?
We just present first.
If we may just present first the sec.
Why don't you, for the orderly proceeding in this case, why don't you finish with the article 2 in relation to the testimony of the previous witness, because the testimony of this summoned witness is connected with that, so that we can finish instead of jumbling the records. Is he here?
Mr. President, may I move to suspend the trial for a minute so that we can thresh this out?
Trial suspended. Are you ready? Try to resume. What's the pleasure of the prosecution?
We will present witness Mr. Noli Hernandez. He's
please
here, Mr.
Swear the
President.
Witness and
please raise your right question. Hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in this before this court?
Yes, Your Honor.
So help you God.
So help me God.
Proceed.
May we request that Attorney Joseph Jomer Perez be recognized to conduct direct examination, Mr. President.
Attorney
Joseph Jomer Perez.
Attorney Perez may proceed with the examination.
Thank you, Your Honor.